Hi, I'm going diving tomorrow at Stoney Cove with my AP XPD Rebreather, and I thought I'd do a short video showing the preparation that I do to put the Rebreather together, and hopefully some nice pictures of the actual dive later. The first step is to put softener lime in. I use Molecular Products 797 grade, which is the recommended grade. Here is the scrubber, and literally we just fill this up. It's quite heavy. Then make sure that it's nicely packed down and give it a few taps all the way around, and then top it back up. The idea is to fill it so it's the main assembly just sits below the rim. You'll see that in a minute. Spread this out, and hopefully I haven't put too much in. Scrim goes on top, and then the spring-loaded assembly goes on there with a retainer. Next step is endless tapping. All I'm trying to do is to make sure all of the lime doesn't compress anymore, but not compress it too much so that it's hard to breathe through. Because this will filter and remove the carbon dioxide from the gas that I breathe out. And there we are. We just need to make sure this edge is flush. Next step is to put the head, which has got the oxygen cells in it, onto the canister with the scrubber cartridge inside and some very important O-rings. I first check that all the plugs are secure. Then I add the mixing chamber onto the assembly into the right position and screw on the retaining nut. Here is the cam. Just make sure there's no dust and anything in it, such as a spider or something along those lines. I tend to make sure the sealing edge is nice and clean as well, no dust on it. Into this goes my scrubber. Check there's nothing rattling around loose in there. And the scrubber goes in. Make sure the springs go up and down and everything's working. And then we put on a ready greased O-ring first, and that goes in. And we make sure it's all the way around here is home, and then we put the spacer ring in. Once that's done, the head can be fitted to the top. Having previously greased the sealing O-ring around here, I will then connect the wires for the temperature stick, which measures the temperature of the scrubber. In here, feed those into the head, secure them, head onto the container. And there we are. Once the head is fully in place and pushed down, there's three turnbuckles which will hold the head in place. And then, having made sure there's no obstructions in my exhale hose, I then fit that. Okay, so here we are fitting the canister to the insides. Oxygen diluent, in this case just air because we're not very deep, probably 30 meters. First things first, try not to break anything. So we put all of the things that are going to go on the front through and we secure them. And that means I can put the exhale hose through there, take the protector off. Connect the oxygen hose. And then just feed the strap that holds it on all the way through till it sits on the ledge. And there we are. Feed all of the control wires through. Next, I'm just going to fit the inhale on top of the scrubber, so this just screws on. And then I'll check the oxygen and diluent good and tight. And there we are. Closes up. We turn it round then. Next, I check the mouthpiece. This is really important because it's got to make sure that gas only comes in from here and flows out to there. There are non-return valves in the mouthpiece to stop it backflowing. So it's a simple. That's all good. I also then do, from the open circuit side of things, a negative test to make sure the diaphragm is holding water out. Next, time to fit the mouthpiece. So I just pop the blue hose on the inhale lung, and then I'll make sure that that just turns so that the mouthpiece is facing up. That makes it the most comfortable. Give them a little twist to make sure the O-rings bed in, and then fit the exhale and the inhale. My hoses and my buzzer are in the right place. This is a buzzer so that if I don't see the lights flashing on a rebreather, I can see the buzzer or hear the buzzer. And then I have a handset, which when fired up, perhaps cover up my personal details. And it tells me cells are working, solenoid and buzzer are working, temperature stick are working, batteries are full, so I've just charged them. You can hear the solenoid clicking. Little self-test on the drain on the battery. I'll go through this, but I'll do the whole thing later. It gives you all these steps. Change the elapsed time to zero because I've recharged the battery. And for now, we won't calibrate sensors, but I'd always calibrate before we dive. And that's telling me 21% oxygen, which is correct, but it should be at 0.7. So we'll turn that off to avoid the beeping. Now it's a case of threading everything through. This is a heads up display. There's four little LEDs in there that tell me whether the unit's working right, and I can see that through my mask. And these just clip on in several places. And then we have the open circuit bailout air supply. And that just screws in here. Okay, so first test on the unit, we do a positive check. So I close the lung valves, close the auto dump free flow protector, and blow up. That then gets left for 5 minutes. So that is the positive test done. There's plenty of pressure still in there, and when I open it, I'm waiting for a whoosh, which I get. Okay, negative test. Suck all the air out and then lock it off. Another 5 minutes. Okay, that's been a good 10 minutes. Hoses have remained crushed down, and there should be a good whoosh when I open it. Yeah, there we go. And I'm also looking for the diaphragm of the ADV. Okay, so we're good to go to move on to the next test. Next stage is to check the wing to make sure I can float. So I turn the gas on, turn that on fully, there we go, that's full. I will just check now for 5 minutes that it does hold gas. I will also check, got 200 bar of diluent, and my auto, my manual add works, and these all plugged in. Same for the oxygen side. The only thing with oxygen is it has to be turned on very, very slowly because there is a risk of fire. So I will just turn the valve so that it's very slowly bleeding up. It should take 2 minutes to reach cylinder pressure. We won't wait for that. And there we are, it's all done. 120 bar. So it's okay for a shallowish dive. Okay. the wing has stayed up. Next stage is to turn on the handset and just check everything calibrates ready for tomorrow. So long button press on the left and you should be able to just see what's going on here. Cells are good, solenoid and buzzer's good, temp stick's good. So open O2, open diluent I've done, check bailout works. On open circuit first. That's all good. I did a negative check earlier. Open counter lungs. These test mushroom pieces, it's what I did earlier. Lapse time, no, I didn't reset that up. Calibrate oxygen sensors. I won't do that today because I'll do that tomorrow. And there we are, it's showing 0.74, 0.73 really, which is 73% oxygen at the current partial pressure of 990 millibars. I will now wait 10 minutes, turn all the cylinders off, and then I'll check the gauges again, which are currently reading 110 bar of oxygen and about 200 bar of dill, just to make sure there's no leaks on the supply side.
Yeah.